inevitable lot of the Indian agent was troubled. But most often the trouble came not from Indians, but from white men, outsiders, intruders.
Coupons, coupons.
Mr. Jeffords, I'm Simon Regis. This is my colleague, Walter Morgan.
How do you do?
Well, you know who we are, of course. Here to make a study for our archaeological foundation.
I know.
I don't know why we've been treated with so much hostility. Grabbed like criminals and held prisoner.
After all, your superiors assured us you'd make all arrangements. You were supposed to contact me at the agency before coming here.
But that was a half a day out of our way. We saw no harm in stopping here first.
You realize that just 2 years ago, these people were killing white men on sight?
You needn't try to frighten us, Mr. Jeffords. We are used to danger.
Well, they seem quite friendly now.
They've signed a peace treaty, yes, and they'll live up to it. But they expect the same from us. Part of it is that no white men enter the reservation without permission.
Well, we've got permission from the head of the Indian Bureau himself. You know that.
I mean permission from the Apaches, from Cochise.
But I...
Mr. Morgan, the Apaches are a proud people and independent. They have every right to expect courtesy from us.
Well, of course, Jeffords. But we meant no offense. And I'm sorry if we stepped on Cochise's toes. But naturally, we supposed that you'd notified him of our coming.
I spoke to him about it. He hasn't yet given his permission.
His permission? We've already told you we come from the top man in the Bureau of Indian Affairs.
Mr. Morgan, you're a long way from Washington. This is the home of the Apaches. You don't force yourself into someone's home without an invitation.
Mr. Jeffords, I thought you had these Apaches under control.
I do not control them. I get along with them by treating them with decency and respect.
Morgan, we didn't come here to quarrel with Mr. Jeffords or with Cochise. What can we do, Mr. Jeffords?
I'll talk with Cochise. Cochise, these are the men I spoke to you about.
You did not say they would come without you.
That was a mistake. They meant no harm.
They carry danger with them. We have been warned. Just before they were seen, a dust devil swept through the camp from the direction of the rising sun. And it was from there they came only a little while later. And last night, the owl hooted in the camp all night. These are warnings of evil.
My brother has lived with us a long time and knows what signs mean to us.
I know.
They must go at once, or they will bring disaster to the camp.
I will speak to them.
No wonder they were hostile. It wasn't just our bad manners.
You heard, Cochise. The Apaches fear nothing in the world that lives. But all of them, even Cochise, fear the evil spirits.
Well, we understand. A hooting owl is an evil omen among many primitive peoples. We've run into it before.
But surely, Jeffords, you can explain
to them. There is nothing you can tell them. They believe completely in such omens.
But you must persuade them to let us stay.
My advice is for you to go back. Forget about it. Come back some other time.
But we must be caught this culture now, as it is, without any civilizing influences. Otherwise, there's no point in our work, don't you see? If you care for these people, as you must, you will want to see their culture recorded.
Cochise, I believe these men are of peace and goodwill. I believe their coming here can be a good thing.
But the omens.
Perhaps the omens have nothing to do with their coming.
No one else has come.
Cochise, these men were sent from Washington to learn your ways. Then it will be written in books so all men can read it and understand the Chiricahua. Then they will no longer fear and distrust and hate the Apache, but will know him. I believe if you allow them to stay, it can be a good thing.
What you ask is a hard thing.
I know. I believe I am right.
I am the one who knows the secrets of the spirits. I say you listen too much to the white man. You drift away from your belief in Child of the Waters. You forsake white painted lady. You defy the spirits of your ancestors.
You have said enough. My brother has said the omens may be for others. Washington wants us to open our camp to them, so they can learn our ways. shall be done. We'll speak no more of omens.
Thank you, Cochise. Thank you very much.
I hope you're all right.
The headdress those dancers are wearing.
It is to drive away the evil spirits. You write much?
The Apaches have no written language, have they?
No. But the ancient ones that dwelled on this land before the Apaches came, they had writings in their caves. The Apaches destroyed the ancient ones.
We must see these writings, Jeffords.
The ancient ones are gone, but the Apache, though he does not write, still remains.
How long have you been chief of the Chiricahuas, Cochise?
Many harvests. We do not mark the passing of time as closely as you.
Who was chief before you? Was it your father? Or perhaps the father of your wife?
Regis.
Tell me about him. Was he killed in battle?
Was his name Mangus Coloradus?
Oh, no. Mangus was chief of the Mimbre Apache. He was shot by soldiers in New Mexico.
Do you still defy the spirits? These men spoke the name of one no longer with us. Take them away. Leave this place. Go.
Professor, it's still 2 hours from the agency.
Didn't you say there were some caves around here, Mr. Jeffords? The ones with the ancient carvings?
We can't stop for that now.
Oh, why not? We're miles away from the Apache camp.
They're still on the reservation. The carvings aren't Apache. They've got no reason to object if we take a look at them.
It would only take a few minutes, Mr. Jeffords. Just time enough for us to trace the carvings. We could study the designs at our leisure when we got back into town. We failed with Cochise. It would be such a shame if we didn't even get this much.
All right, but we'll have to make it fast.
More of these caves around here?
Yes, seeing lots of them.
Look how the rock formation building up on the bottom of the cave has covered some of the symbols. You know, these pictographs could be older than any I ever found in the United States. They could go back for thousands of years. Well, let's clear away some of the silt and see how far down we have to go.
Well,
Jeffords. Jeffords.
Could this be an Apache shield?
You bet it is. You've just stumbled onto an Apache grave. Disturbing a grave is the worst offense you can commit against the Apache. Start packing this dirt back exactly the way you found it. I'll get some brush to brush out our tracks.
Well, just a minute. I'm not going to run off and leave a find like these carvings. Why, they might give us a clue to the whole question of Indian origin.
Forget it, Professor. You saw what happened last night when you only mentioned the dead.
Let's trace all the carvings that are uncovered.
The ways of my people. You've lived among us, eaten our food, shared our ceremonies. Yet you have taken these men to a forbidden place.
Cochise, we did not know there was anything Apache in the cave. We went only to see the writings of the ancient peoples.
They were told to leave. They tried to trick us.
No, Katina. I am telling the truth.
When will we learn that our old way of dealing with the white man was the right way?
What you have done is a serious thing.
I know. As soon as we realized it was a sacred place, we left it.
That does not matter. They touch things that belong to one from the dark places. They have awakened a fearful ghost. There is only one way to save ourselves. Put the ghost to rest by destroying the ones who disturbed his sleep.
Cochise, you cannot allow such a thing.
They must be allowed to go without harm.
Hear me, Cochise. If you let the white eyes go, the winter will be long and hard. Our children will go hungry. There will be sickness in every family. And the ghost will take many back with him to the dark places. Already Nogalo has been struck down.
Let the spirits hear me. And bear witness that my people are not to blame for this thing. I, Cochise, am alone to blame. May the torments of hunger and cold and sickness and death come to me alone. Take them and go quickly.
But do not return. The next time there will be no mercy for any of you.
Brother. I must put the welfare of my people ahead of all else.
Now, let's assume that this is the symbol for the rain, and this is for the water.
There's no basis for that.
There is if these characters are derived from the Aztec.
Your bunks are ready. You can turn in now.
After a while, I want to go over these some more.
You've got a long trip ahead of you. You can study those in Tucson.
Mr. Jeffords is right. We need all the rest we can get.
Oh. All right. We're sorry about what happened, Jeffords. But I don't see how any of us could have known.
I shouldn't have taken you to the cave.
Don't worry about it. It'll all blow over in a few weeks. Cochise will send for you, welcome you back as though nothing had happened.
We'll see.
I'm sure he will. You know, he's quite a fellow, that Cochise. He's all right. Taking all the blame on himself to save us.
Gentlemen, come and get it.
Hey, good morning, good morning. Boy, that bed was welcome for a change. Slept like a top. Didn't even hear Regis get up.
Regis is up?
Well, he's not in there. His horse is gone. Where are you going?
To get him.
Argue me out of this. This is too important to find. Come on.
Wait a moment, Jeffords.
I'm not leaving until I finish my work.
Come
here. Go.
I'm not going to fight you.
They'd rather be tortured to death than come in here.
They're sealing us in.
We're gonna make a break for it. It'll have to be now.
Do you think we'll have a chance?
I'd rather die out there than suffocate in here.
All right. Let's go.
Regis?
Regis!
Stop! You cannot stop them. For you have not heard the warning of White Painted Lady. You defied the omens and brought the revenge of the spirits on your people.
I prayed for it to fall only upon myself.
Your prayer was not answered. Did not the ghost take Nogalo to the dark place before your very eyes?
You cannot do this thing. I command it.
You cannot command it. In these things of the spirits, the Chiricahua still listen to me. When the ghosts speak, no man can command against them.
Kill him. No, wait!
There is no need to fear any ghosts. There is no Apache grave in the cave.
You say that when in your hand you hold an Apache spear from the grave?
There are spears and shields and knives, but no bones. Not of a man nor of a horse that would have been buried with him.
He lies. If that is no grave, how did Apache weapons come to be there?
They must have been hidden there before the peace.
Kill him before he comes closer and destroys us all.
Katina, see for yourself. Go inside. There's no danger.
You see? He wants to destroy me. Whoever goes into the cave will be captured by the spirits of the departed. He too will have to die. I say again, kill him now before it is too late.
No. I will go into the cave.
No.
Place myself and the welfare of my people in your hands.
Cochise, you will be doomed.
Cochise,
it is no grave, but the one who was called Nogalo is dead. The dust devil was seen. The owl hooted not once, but twice. We are still under the curse of the spirits.
Now you will listen to me. The spirits speak in many ways. They have just spoken to you in the courage of your chief, Cochise. Such courage wipes out all evil omens.
Let it be so.
Return with me to the stronghold. Once again, it is your home.